In order to easily apply this control methodology, we have developed a software package called eTeSL, the expression graph-based task specification language. Using this software, we can specify a task in terms of constraints with a first-order behavior. At the framework level, it uses instantaneous optimization. In other words, eTeSL itself does not look ahead in time. We also only use a first-order behavior for constraints and only consider a kinematic model of the robot, but as you will see in the examples, we can still achieve a very high performance. eTeSL uses a concept of expression graphs. These are symbolic expressions that are represented by a graph structure, and these are not only scalar expressions, but they can also be valued in, for example, orientation matrix, transformation matrices, vectors, twists, wrenches, and so on. Robots are also described as a function of these joint variables using such an expression. The same thing for trajectories, they are also expressions in function of time. Expressions can also relate to the sensor inputs. And at the end, there is a simple language, Lua-based, where you can write these expressions down like you would on paper, and the graph structure is automatically built. Using this expression, the controller can be automatically generated because we can evaluate these expressions, we can do introspection, we can see the dependencies on which variables these expressions depend, and we can also do automatic differentiations so that we can automatically compute the Jacobians. And we do this in a smart way that avoids any representational singularities. Similarly, for a Jacobian where you have a geometric Jacobian and an analytical Jacobian, our automatic differentiation also uses geometric derivatives. So an orientation matrix, its derivative is represented by a rotational velocity, and not an orientation is not represented by Euler zyx angles and its derivatives by the derivatives of Euler zyx angles. This would lead to singularities, representational singularities that are avoidable. So another concept in eTeSL that is very important are feature variables. These feature variables are borrowed from an older framework called iTask. In iTask, the task specification was done using virtual kinematic chains, which were in fact a kind of virtual robot, 6 degrees of freedom with a 6 degree of freedom task space. And the task itself was specified by specifying specific values or trajectories for each of the joints of this virtual kinematic robot. Our approach has extended this approach, and by having an arbitrary number of feature variables and also an arbitrary number of constraints. Our expressions are also not only in frames, but can also be in points or scalar values or whatever. Using these extensions, we can, for example, model the geometry using these constraints in a way that's a little bit more efficient and more robust against singularities than iTask. Take, for example, distance between two cylinders. If you would do this with the iTask approach, you will have to define a kind of virtual kinematic robot, but you will have sometimes problems when this virtual kinematic robot, virtual kinematic chain, is in a singular position. In our approach, we can define two points on the axis of the cylinders, defined by feature variables F1 and F2. We can then define a line between these two points and express that this line should be perpendicular to the first axis of the cylinder and perpendicular to the second axis. In this way, we can avoid many of the singularities that iTask suffers from. Of course, in eTeSL, it's a constraint-based task specification framework, so we can specify constraints. These constraints are typically related to the task, the desired trajectory, the speed, contact force, the distance, but it can also be related to the robot platform and its limitations in terms of the reachable or allowable joint positions and velocities, And we typically specify this robot platform using standard UFDF. It can also be a description of things in the environment, and it can also be a description of interactions with humans. And it's important to notice that all these different items are in fact quite separately specified, and so this is very modular. The same task can be used with a different robot platform in a different environment, and perhaps with or without interaction with a human. And so there's a large modularity in this constraint-based approach. These constraints can be, of course, conflicting, and there are two ways to resolve this in Airtable. On one end, we can assign priorities. We can make one constraint a hard priority, hard constraint. We can make the other constraint a soft constraint, and then the hard constraint will have priority. Or we can also assign weights to the soft constraints such that the weighted sum of this constraints is minimized. The constraints can be, of course, equality or inequality constraints. An example of such an inequality constraint is, for example, a collision constraint. And typically in Airtable is also that all the expressions involved can be explicitly dependent on time. For example, the task function expressions, they can be explicitly depending on time, but also the weights of the constraints can be explicitly depending on time. And Airtable always deals perfectly with the tracking errors. It always computes the optimal feed forward just to minimize these tracking errors. And that comes, in fact, for free.